You know about climate change, the idea that basically greenhouse gases are trapping heat from outside, and you are correct. They're now well over 90% saying that human activity is responsible for the preponderance of this. Important to note, they're saying there are other factors, but the preponderance of it is coming as a result of humans doing this. So what is the result of all of this? Rising oceans. Why? Because we have warmer oceans, and those warmer oceans are causing melting ice caps, and beyond that, melting of glaciers and other large ice areas in the world, for example, Greenland. And I want you to watch this amazing piece of animation from NASA here, tracking over the past few years what's been happening to ice up in Greenland. You see all these light blue areas around the edge there? That's where the ice has been steadily melting and retreating in this entire country of Greenland. And as you go on through the years, this is about 2005 here, as it moves forward, you start seeing even the middle of the country here as it starts warming up, and they're losing even more and more ice. By the time you get through this entire animation, what you see is that NASA has captured how basically this entire area has seen significant loss in ice, all of which goes out into the oceans, Jake. And that's the real key here, the concern about what that's going to add up to in the long run.
And Tom, what about the effects on American cities?
Yeah, that's the thing that most people are most concerned about here. Let's take a look at that. If we move on beyond this, and you look at Miami down here. This is where Miami is right now, Everglades National Park. It's a little bit hard to see, but I want you to watch as this progresses. What they're predicting is that over the next 80 or 90 years, if nothing changes, what you would see is a real encroachment. Areas like this down here where you have the Florida Keys, they would basically go completely underwater, and a lot of areas would also be affected by much, much higher water levels. And even if you go up to major cities like New York City, for example, look at this. This is the island of Manhattan right here, right now. This is the edge of it, and you can see that's where the new edge would be. All of this out in here would be lost. What would that include? Well, the simple truth is if you had it lost all the way out there, you would see things like Wall Street essentially starting to go underwater. You would see the Statue of Liberty, the island that supports it out here, starting to go underwater. Does that mean it'll happen? No, we have a lot of time in which people could build levees, that sort of thing, to keep it back. But it does mean it would become a genuine problem if this goes on unabated. And that's what this whole debate is about, Jake. And now there's an even greater agreement among all these climate scientists from around the world that, in fact, humans are making some of this happen, and only humans can stop it from happening worse.